The next one is called our angular momentum quantum number. This one deals with the shape. So remember, this one deals with the shape of the atomic orbital. Remember all those shapes that I had you memorize for S, P, D, and F. Those shapes are determined by this quantum number, the angular momentum quantum number. And we're going to say each atomic orbital has a specific shape, which we just said. We say that the variable for the angular momentum quantum number is L. And we're going to say that it also uses the formula N minus 1. And we'll see when do we use these the L value, when do we use the N minus 1 value. Now, if we know the sublevel letter, we know what the L value is. So if the sublevel is S, then L is 0. If it's P, it's 1. D, it's 2. F, it's 3. Remember, I told you that there's more than just those four sublevels. It goes beyond F. We have G. We also have H. Usually you don't see G and H, but just realize that those exist as well. And each of them, if you know the sublevel letter, then you know what the L value is. Now, if we don't know the sublevel letter, that's when we use this formula, N minus 1. We'll see how that works when we put to practice calculating things dealing with the quantum numbers. Okay, so far we've done the principle. So now we've just done the angular momentum. If we go back up, we could figure out what the L value is for each of these. Because we're going to say that the number designates our N value, but the letter, the sublevel letter, designates our L value. So if it's P, L is 1. If it's S, L is 0. If it's D, L is 2. If it's F, L is 3. So far we know the first two quantum numbers. Now it's time to take a look at the third one.